International Rugby back at ANZ Stadium in Sydney. It's been an overcast day, quite a few showers earlier, and it's threatening at the moment, but let's hope that the rain does stay away. Let's go through the visitors with Phil Kearns.
Yeah, quite a big front row, Clarkey. Both those props, 118 kilos. Schwalger, the skipper, around about 106, very mobile man. Two big locks, not in height, but they're very, very solid. They're both around 198 centimetres, so they're shorter than the Australian combination, but get around the park well. And this is a dynamic back row. They get through plenty of work. Stows and Tuafua in particular, watch them running the footy. They are very, very good.
Any fans of Super Rugby would know Kaan Fatuoli'i, the halfback with the Crusaders, come on in the last few weeks and been magnificent. His combo with PC, who plies his trade over in Japan, they're quite good together, these two. Mapasua, former Highlander, and George PC. What a strong runner, Mapasua. Watch him step off the right foot all night. Very skillful. At the back, Paul Williams, former Auckland player. He's made his allegiance to Samoa, and they've been so happy with him in the last 2 years. Tangi Thakavau, outstanding winger, especially in sevens, transfers it to the 15s.
And also Tuolungi on the left wing is a big mobile outside back in the Wallabies. Well, there'll be a few nerves in there because they have a few debutants. Robbie Dean's the coach, just doing the final rounds. And up front, Kepu, good to see him back. Moore and Alexander.
Yeah, it is, with no Robinson around. I mean, this is a good front row. Kepu, Ben Alexander will look for a big lift in his form. Had a bit average year with the Brumbies, so he's looking to lift his form. These are the two big guys, Sharp and Tamani. To me, they're going to control the forward battle out there tonight, particularly at line-out time. And Rocky Elson, great to see him back. Let's hope he has a great game because he can set the tone of this Wallaby season from here tonight.
Well, at halfback, we got Nick Phipps, of course, an outstanding season with the Rebels. He's playing his debut, and Matt Gitto, he's trying to hang on to his Wallaby jersey. Gets his chance at fly half. It might be inside centre. We see him later in the season with the Wallabies. Pat McCabe, his run on debut. Adam Ashley Cooper, hoping for it. Well, he was pretty quiet during the Super Rugby season, but he's played the last 10 tests at outside centre for the Wallabies. He's settled in this arena. Mark Gerrard, welcome back. It's been 2007, the last time he put a Wallaby jersey on. Rod Davies, his debut, and Digby Ioane. Can he maintain that wonderful form?
First international of 2011 for Australia underway. And it's loose from the kickoff, but cleaned up by Somoa. Oh, big tackle there on the number seven, Maori Fa'afasalu.
Who made that hit? Was that Matt Gitto?
Pat McCabe.
Pat McCabe, was it? Gee.
Thompson. So an early touch here for the visitors. PC gets it out to Mapasua, brings in Tuolungi, and he got rid of Davies. No problem whatsoever. Fatuoli'i for PC. And once again, it goes to Savalu.
Leave it! Leave!
To the left side. And now the kick. Not a real chase at all.
Stop,
and there's the kick downtown.
Stop.
From Mark Gerrard, back in Wallaby Gold.
Is it not out?
All good.
Play on. Playing advantage, one offside.
So advantage being played here. Kepu was offside and Williams got it back to the halfway or almost. Fatuoli'i, PC.
No advantage, number one in front of the kicker, advancing.
Oh, Kepu didn't stand still. He kept moving forward when Gerrard kicked that. What an afternoon we're in for if that's what we're going to see. Samoans have tossed it crazy. Here's Pat McCabe. We made mention of that hit. He was off balance slightly. Fa'asabolo.
Number one.
First shot for Samoa. Not a bad strike. Very good indeed. The radar was working, and so Mamu Samoa had the first points at ANZ Stadium through the boot of Tusi Pisi. And it is 3-0, Samoa.
We'll be taking a photo of that scoreboard, the Samoans. There's the Wallaby bench, Dan Vickerman, back in the Wallaby lineup.
Taken this time by Taiasina Tuafua.
It is inside.
Oh, pick up.
George Stowers. What do Aliti do? He's here and he goes high. Well taken by the Wallabies. was Nick Phipps on debut, and he offloaded. They're up to the 22. So an opportunity for Australia to hit back here. They go to the short side, playing advantage here as Giddo throws the dummy. They don't fall for it. Tackle made by Schwalger, still playing advantage. Phipps to Stephen Moore. He's taken by Thompson. And now Kepu in his best season of rugby. Sokopi Kepu. Now it's McKelman. Nowhere through there. So what do they do here? Will they take the three and try and settle things down?
This could the decision here could gauge the intent of the Wallabies. No, yeah. They're going to have a run. Line out and then take it on.
So Matt Giddo in his 92nd test match finds touch on the far side.
Clarkey, good early decision there from the captain, Rocky Elson, electing to keep the pressure on. I think the Wallabies will fancy themselves at the set piece, particularly line out, and will look to drive, try to establish some dominance there. I think that'll be something the Samoans will keep it away from the touchlines. We've seen them kick twice and keep the ball in field.
Moore finds Sharp. Moore taken by Thompson, and now the drive coming in from Samoa, causing a few problems there, but a penalty.
Well, courageous stuff by Nick Phipps to pluck that ball out despite the pressure he's under from Danny Leo.
And again, Giddo looks to the touchline. What about conditions? The ground looks reasonably heavy, Kate.
It is a bit heavy. There's been a lot of rain in Sydney in recent times. The ground is heavy, but and it's sort of that sort of deep wetness down in the, under the surface. So it sort of gives you that heavy leg feeling when you're running on it, which I think will favour the Wallabies. You know, they're a little bit sort of lighter, particularly in the fleet of foot in the back line. But time will tell as this game goes on.
Well, they're asking some questions of the Samoa defence now. Wallabies, 7 or 8 metres out.
They've done well, the Samoans.
Now here's McCabe with that typical straight running action of his. Phipps to Sharp. Nathan Sharp. Half a gap open. And they've lost it forward now.
There's some pressure at the breakdown coming through from the Samoans.
Accidental offside.
Sure, the Wallabies getting out of the advantage line, but what happens after the tackle is where the havoc is being created. Sharp almost hit the gap.
Call as accidental offside.
Where's your number nine? Number nine. We can have a look at the television afterwards. They pick up the ball and play, please.
There's a lot of interference on Nick Phipps.
Yeah, there's the mark.
Really getting through pressure, and you cannot touch the halfback.
I think the other thing that's obvious, Kearns, in those first couple of rucks, they're not real accurate, the Wallabies at the moment. They're sort of a bit unsure of who's going to be running the ball, who's taking it, and they're missing the clean out.
Touch. Pause. In game. Ball is out. Play.
Easy with the clearing kick and finding touch up around the 10-metre mark. Still in Samoa territory.
It's a good scrum from the Samoans then.
Get them on the line. Gold on the line.
Nice and solid in position.
On the line,
got the side up that they wanted.
World rankings, Australia 2. Of course, New Zealand number 1. And Samoa moved to 10th. Advantage. Lost forward by the Wallabies. And advantage over now with the kick. So Rod Davies fires it across to Mark Gerrard. What a great pass. And the bounce is there eventually for Adam Ashley Cooper. But he's tackled by Mapasua. Phipps to Giddo. Now Nathan Sharp. To a fool made the tackle. Giddo punching it down over the head of the last man back there for Samoa. PC.
Stop, Blue! Stop! Stop here!
It's not out.
You're on now, play.
Gerrard, better pass this time into Davies. And now Digby Ioane. Of course, Digby is Samoan. He was saying during the week he was really looking forward to taking on the Samoans here, and now Tomani, the big Tongan, up towards the 22. Samoa leading 3-0. Pass out in the midfield, ooh, picked up there by McKelvin, and he was immediately picked up by George Stowers. Now, Ioane from a standing start. Beat one, can't get past Mapasua. Phipps, now to Giddo down the short side. Adam Ashley Cooper. Good tackle coming in from George Peasy, the opposite 13. Now it's Alexander. Short side again. Quick hands. McCabe. Oh, hammered over there. Samoans in the stand on the far side. Pretty happy with that defence. Now here's McKelman. And this time Thompson comes up to shut him down. Giddo, inside ball to nobody. Ioane overran it, then it was cleaned up by Phipps and he got it off to Alexander. Giddo again. Hands it off to Tamani, pops it over to Hodgson. Matt Hodgson will need some support. It's play on, great work, and look now out. Tuolagi. He's only got Giddo to beat. Olasana Tuolagi puts a goose step on, too good. The big man will score the first try, a runaway. Olasana Tuolagi, the man from Leicester.
Oh, Tuolagi, you can see him on YouTube and now we watch him live. It wasn't a bullocking run like we normally see for him. He's just outskirted. Well, there was only the one chase and Matt Giddo after the dramatic turnover. I'd like to have a look at the circumstances. A little bit of doubt and then the quick pass.
There's nothing wrong with this. They just put pressure on him. There was only one man helping. It was Mark Gerrard. And look, they just drove through, spat out the side, through the legs, and away we go to Olangi.
Rod Davies there, the man who could have caught him. He was lying at the bottom of the ruck. The smile starts now, 40 out, because he knows he's going to beat Matt Giddo, simply because he outweighs him by 30 kilograms. And then the dive. Earthquake stuff. What a try to Olangi.
Well, the Wallabies seem to be a little frustrated over the far side. A lot of shifting the ball sideways because they're having trouble penetrating this Samoan defence. Been very solid so far.
He's got the radar working.
What a shot. And a lot of people wondering, the local TAB here, $13 Samoa were playing pre-match in a two-horse race.
13th minute, Manu Samoa 10, Australia 0. 12 and a half minutes gone. So Giddo with the restart. Down to Ottawa Leahy. And offloads to forward coming round. And now penalty.
Off your feet. Off your feet. Run away.
Taisina Tuafu, the blindside flanker, plays for Counties Manukau. Yeah, New Zealand got a couple of caps with the Chiefs in 2011. And so, PC.
Stop time wasting, please play.
We'll look for touch. Rod Kafer, this is just the perfect start for the visitors. So, no rake outsiders at the start of the game, and people thought that they might not have enough petrol in the tank to go the full distance against the Wallabies, but so far so good.
Well, it's only 13 minutes, Clark. It's not quite the full distance yet, so plenty of time, but this is what we expect from the Samoans. Lots of short line-outs. They'll play 4- and 5-man line-outs and look to hit in the midfield and come back on the short side, that sort of stuff.
The double round that time. Easy just manages to hold on. Still inside their own territory. Fotu'ali'i from the Crusaders. He stayed on in Australia after the Super Rugby final against the Reds last weekend. To the short side they go, and Thompson. He's tackled. Good recycling from Samoa, and now BC goes to the air. And Giddo is back there and can't control it. Picked up by Samoa. And it's been knocked on by Samoa, unfortunately for them.
Well, again, their whole game's based on pressure, whether it's in the tackle, whether it's at the breakdown, and now chasing kicks. And it's working against the Wallabies, who are looking a little bit rusty.
Yeah, both the